Okay, so what I mean, whatever you are inventing from the big jungle of that area, you need to protect the invention in a proper way. So how you are going to protect that invention? By filing application at the Indian Patent Office, right? So at the Indian Patent Office, how can we file that your invention? We can file by filing provisional application or by filing complete specification. When to file provisional application? I mean, I'll just brief you. See, you can see the chart where it's just given a patent flow chart. See, filing of patent application, you can file provisional specification or you can file complete specification. Provisional specification, when you file provisional specification to get the earliest priority date, within 12 months you need to file complete specification. When to file provisional specification? When your invention is in a conceptual idea. I mean, when you are just thinking about the invention, ki how it should go further, and this is my invention. But for that, you need to carry out the experimentation. Experimentation to prove that your invention is this, and this is the correct invention I'm going to file at the Indian Patent Office. So for filing provisional specification, you need just concept. You just have to get the earliest priority date at the Indian Patent Office. So when you are filing provisional specification with concept, you need to check on the fact that you are covering your invention broadly and you are not missing on any part of your invention, because your concept is there. It's not, at this stage you are not thinking, okay, how it will come up with the results and how this will go further, and etc. etc. So you need to file your invention with a broader scope of invention. So what is the preamble of provisional specification? You need to file Form 2 for filing provisional specification, wherein the preamble is the following specification describes the invention. That is the only thing you need to write on page 2, Form 2. You can go to Indian Patent Office and you can see any, just for your awareness, how that Form 1 and Form 2 are filed. So, provisional specification, the concern is to tell you that provisional specification is to get the earliest priority date with the concepts. And complete specification is the specification which particularly describes the invention and the manner which it is to be performed. What does that mean? See, if suppose I thought, okay, I'm planning to claim shampoo composition. I got an idea, okay, if my surfactant, if one of my surfactant is adding addition of that surfactant in the composition is giving me so surprising result. But you don't know which all surfactants will act in a similar way. So what you will do, you will just file the shampoo composition along with the broader term surfactant, and then you will go for complete specification within 12 months. In that complete specification, you need to show how this surfactant is giving surprising result in view of the prior art. Because see, there are so many shampoo compositions are present in the prior art or in the market, and you need to define your invention. Like, you need to have your invention novel, inventive, and utility. That maybe Surabhi has told you, okay, what is the three aspects of the filing while filing patent. Your patent should, I mean, your invention should be novel, your invention should not be obvious to a person skilled in that, and it should have an industrial applicability. So while filing provisional specification, what you need for filing provisional specification, you need Form 1, Form 2, that is specification which we drafted, drawing, if any drawing you are providing, Form 5, that is a declaration of inventorship, Form 26, which is a power of authority, and Form 3, if we are filing foreign filing details, because we need to tell the patent office that we are filing outside or we are not. That is as per act, as per the Indian Patent Act. And on the contrary, for filing complete specification, we need filing document, that is CS, along with Form 1, Form 2, drawing, Form 3, Form 18, if you want to file request for examination at the time of CS filing. And what is the difference of PS and CS? See, PS, content of PS will be only title of invention, field of invention, background, objects and description. And what is the content of complete specification? It is title, field, background, object, summary, brief description of drawing, if any, detailed description, experimental details, technical advancement, claims, which is really important part of the complete specification for which the inventors are getting rights, abstract and sequence listing, if any. So, why to file provisional specification first of all? If you are in a concept, in a concept stage, what is the need of filing for provisional, you know, because I'll get it done by experiments and then only I'll file. No, you should not do that, because first to our patent system is what, first to file system. Whoever files first application first, he or she gets the patent. So you need to file your invention as soon as possible when you get an idea to secure the earliest priority date by filing provisional specification. So provisional, like I mentioned here, provisional specification contains only broad specification of the invention, and we are not claiming anything in the provisional specification. Moreover, please understand that you will get rights, legal rights for the claims of the invention, which we will be filing in the complete specification. So what does this provisional specific application does? Why to file? To secure filing date. See, it will not get published on IPO. So your invention will be secure as it is. Nobody knows. So inventor will get 12 months time period to complete the experiments and file the specification. And you can write, you know, patent pending in your on your product or wherever you want to communicate, or you can discuss in your group or something like that. But before that, you should not discuss your invention in your group also before filing the provisional specification. Okay, now contents, as I just mentioned, provisional specification. While filing provisional specification, you just mentioned, I mean, points to be remembered that patent cannot be obtained on provisional specification. This is just a provision to get earliest priority date. Complete specification should be filed within 12 months from the provisional specification. Any developments outside the scope of invention cannot be claimed in the CS. That's why your provisional specification should be covered very broadly. And in the provisional specification, you should not write such terms like must have or essential or it must contain. You should broadly describe your invention. I mean, you know, it may contain this, but other suitable known things can also be used. Likewise, you can just write in a provisional specification. So complete specification, what we can say, is a techno-legal document containing full scientific details of the invention and claims that define the legal limits of the invention. Documents is written in such a way that the person skilled in the art may be able to perform the invention. Now, the concern, you know, I can say like innovation is the art of making difficult things simple. On the contrary, patent application writing, patent specification writing is a, writing a simple things, in a simple language, but that should sound complicated because this is a techno-legal document and you are getting legal rights for the claims. So writing claims is just, you know, it just, it's a very good art, or you can say it's very exciting thing to draft claims for each different inventions. So if we can say complete specification, these are the contents of complete specification. should be having. Now, just to brief you about complete specification, you can file a complete specification directly if you have data. Else, as I said, it can be filed as a provisional specification, and within 12 months from the priority date of the provisional specification, complete specification is required to file. Now, complete specification, jab hum file, we are filing at the IPO, this application, this specification will get published on IPO at the Indian Patent Office from within 18 months from the priority date. Means, for example, if you are filing today complete specification, then within 18 months, Indian Patent Office will publish your document at the Indian Patent Office. But if you are filing today PS, then within 1 year, you need to file complete specification, and from today's date, within 18 months, the patent application get published at the Indian Patent Office. So in the complete specification, that invention need to be disclosed in a sufficient detail. Again, can write patent pending after filing complete specification also, and can postdate the application also if required, if inventors will not get any data or something like that. Now, actual drafting, how to draft the complete specification or provisional specification. So at the first instance, when we are filing form 2, that is provisional or complete specification, so at the time we can write title. We have to write title. Title should be provided on first page of form 2. That should indicate the subject matter. I mean, generally, very broadly, that should indicate the subject matter. It should not be more than 15 words as per Indian Patent Act. It should be free from fancy expression or ambiguity, such as, some people write novel, improved, enhanced, or some fancy word that should be avoided. And then inventor name, the work patent, words in other languages, and so on should not be included in title. The title should correspond to the broadest claim, that is preamble of the claim. Maybe I'll explain you what is preamble of claim and what is the body of claim, and should cover all aspect of the invention, that is product or process. Then in the second page of form 2 that starts on start should include field of invention. You can generally say okay, the present invention relates to so and so, broadly, maybe chemistry, organic chemistry, and particularly they're saying particularly the invention relates to shampoo composition, maybe personal care composition, likewise. Then after that, you need to write background. You can just mention nowadays these are the recent trends going on in personal care. As I'm giving example of shampoo composition, I'm just talking about that. So you can just say what is going on in personal care composition, and what is the problem, if you know what is the problem happening in that. People are getting due to use of synthetic component, people are not, that is not safe for people or pets or children's. So I'm coming up with this, safe shampoo composition that can be used. So that kind of background you should write in the background section. And I feel you should not mention any patent document or any non-patent document in the background, saying that these people are disclosing that and I'm disclosing that, because at the time of examination, controller or the examiner may cite same document saying this is the invention already known, and what is inventing in your invention. So proving that thing is very difficult at some extent. So instead of mentioning any like patent or non-patent literature, just write a general background about that invention. And exaggerate nahi karna hai. I mean, you should not exaggerate ki baki logon ka kaise galat hai. These people are really doing bad inventions and mine is great and so on. You should not write that in the background. You just write general comments and saying ki this is the problem in the prior art or in the current situation, and we are just giving this solution for such this problem. that should be taken care of while writing background. After background, you need to write object of the invention. What should be your object? Okay, your shampoo composition. For example, I'm taking shampoo composition. Your shampoo composition should be safe. You can write, okay, it is an object of the present disclosure to provide shampoo composition. Again, you can, second object will be the shampoo composition that is safe, environment friendly, or economy, or etc. etc. Then third thing, that shampoo composition may that provides, that is efficient. And fourth object will be your process for preparation of shampoo composition. So the objective of invention should be broad. The results or advantage, whatever you are getting from the invention, should be included in a broader way in the objects to prove that how my invention is, you know, inventive or not obvious to a person skilled in the art in respect of the cited prior art. So likewise, we need to write now summary. That summary should be concise, and summary should be written in a paragraph. The independent claim, what we are claiming, that should be written in a summary portion. And it's not required to write dependent claim in the summary section. So then brief description of drawing. If we can, you know, clearly indicate the drawing, like any shampoo composition, if any bottle ka aap agar patent application lena chah rahe ho, to that bottle or that ease of application, that can be mentioned in that bottle or something like that. If required, you need to provide drawings, and that should be after summary section, that brief description of drawing. And then you can write, okay, how many figures you have, like figure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever. So that figure should be explained in a manner ki, okay, this is in accordance and this is as per prior art, to show how my invention is inventive. Now, after it, this brief description, you need to write on detailed description. So detailed description is what? It should provide a sufficient detail of the invention. Sufficient detail means what? Like if you are going for composition claim or if you are going for process claim, that should be written in a manner that, see, claim should be written a broader way, but your detailed description should be written in a concise way also, along with coverage of broader claim. Like sufficient details of process parameters or reaction conditions can be should be given in the detailed description. Detailed description should be explained in depth so the person skilled in the art can practice the invention after 20 years of your, you know, expiry of the patent. Invention should be explained with the help of drawing if required. Best mode of invention should be given, and terminology should be consistent throughout the draft. Now, claim drafting, which is really, really important part of the invention. Because on that only the inventors are getting rights, and the inventors are allowing other people, stopping other people from manufacturing, selling, or etc. Means you can't you can stop people from using your invention. So claims is the important parts of the specification drafting. So in this, what happens when a natural person, when a single entity is applying for a patent, that person should write I claim, then semicolon. Or if a company like maybe Samsung or any other big entity is filing patent, that they should write we claim. Means more than one person or a big entity, they should write we claim in the claim section. Then claim should be written in such a way that it should disclose the invention, but it should be broadly covered. You should not exactly pinpoint in your invention in the claim one itself. That you can explain in description, but the broader coverage should be should be claimed for which you are getting rights, the inventors are getting rights from the Indian Patent Office. I'll just explain what is now claim is. I was just mentioning independent claim and dependent claim. So independent claim, first claim, your primary claim will be independent claim. That is main claim, and that may contains product, method. Product claim contains subject of the invention and technical feature, and method claim contains your process parameters, etc. Then on the claim, independent claim, you can depend the claim saying that this is the feature, technical feature of the invention, because you need to cover your claim broadly in the claim section. So independent claim should stand alone, should be broad but within the scope of invention, and single sentence ended with the period. This is really important, because you can't just, you know, make statements and just going to write claim one. It should be a single statement. If you are starting with a shampoo composition, it should end with something, some essential parameter. And the dependent claim, which is independent claim, should read with that claim. It should have a narrow scope, and multiple dependency can be also taken in India. Now see, I was just referring to preamble and transitional phase and body. This is the type of claim, I can say, maybe a coating composition or a shampoo composition for paint. Said composition comprising. Use of word comprising is a transitional phase, and comprising is a broad term. You should not use the word essentially consisting of, or consist of, or includes in this manner. It must be comprising. A coating composition is a preamble of the invention. That means what? This is their invention. This is the broader way of invention. They want to file a coating composition. Maybe sometimes people don't write for paint also. They can just write, okay, a coating composition. And said composition comprising component A, component B, and component C. So this is the body of claim. Hello.
Yes.
Okay. Sir. So everyone is getting any, I mean, anyone has doubt, anything, you can just, you know, write to ask me. It's really difficult, you know. I don't understand if people are understanding or not this. Yes. Whatever I'm talking.
Yes, participants can raise their queries in chat box if they not understand any point.
Right.
Ma'am, participants are mainly the postgraduate students, MPharm. Graduate students and the faculty members from most of them are from the pharmacy background.
Acha.
Yes.
So they should actually very much aware of this patenting system, and they should file the invention, as these people are doing research in their labs. And I feel ki these people just go for publication, but before going for publication, you just file provisional specification, then you can go for publication, and then file complete specification. That okay. Should be done by the student and the faculty members. I just request ki otherwise awareness will not be, you know, happen in this IPR area.
Yes.
Okay. So comprising will be like is an open term saying including the following but not excluding others. Means comprising is a very broad term, and you should retain that term either as a transitional phase in the claims, and should not write consisting, because consisting is a closed term saying that including this only, ABC. But comprising says, okay, ABC is there, but I can add D if I want. Means that can be covered in a dependent claim, that D can be covered in a dependent claim, and maybe controller may object at the time of examination or at the time of prosecution. That time we can take that D component as the essential component in claim one by amending claim at the prosecution stage, say, and saying, okay, now this is my invention. So amendments can be done at any stage in the before till grant. Therefore, your claim should be as broad as possible, but within the scope of invention. Again, then the transitional phase, like consisting essentially, should be avoided. because this is a partly open and partly closed term, saying including the following elements and excluding additional unspecified ingredients which would affect the basic and novel characteristics of the product defined in the balance of claim. So better to use comprising in the transitional phase when you are drafting claims. Got it? These are very basic thing, you know, while drafting claims. Now, for example, see, now I really appreciate if anyone can tell me if this is the claim. This is just example I'm giving, a shampoo composition comprising 25% of alkyl ether sulfate, 10% of dimethicone, 2% of imidazole, and 63% of water. This total will go to this 100%. And now this is the invention of someone, some inventor. So if he will write claim in like example one, will that be, I mean, is that correct way to write claim as per our discussion now? It's not correct way to write claim, because I just told you that your invention should be covered broadly, but within the scope of invention. So if you see claim two, what I'm doing, I'm broadening the scope of invention. I'm broadening the percentage of alkyl ether sulfate. I'm broadening the scope of dimethicone, and I'm broadening the scope of imidazole also. Because if we file specification along with the first exam, according to example one, what will happen? Any person, any other person come up with saying, okay, if that person uses 26% of alkyl ether sulfate and 11% and 15% of dimethicone and 5% of imidazole, you can't stop that person to, you know, use your invention, because what you did, you mistakenly write in claim one, independent claim one, my invention is only restricted to 25% of alkyl ether sulfate. But as a patent drafter, you should have thought, okay, 25%, any human error, 24 or 26 is just a human error, and that can be worked, that invention can be worked on 24% also. So you should give a broader range, like 20 to 30% of at least one surfactant, and your best result is 25% PRM. Then you are 5 to 15% of conditioning agent, because you are, see what I did, you are directly writing alkyl ether sulfate in claim one, which is really wrong. You should write your invention as a 20 to 30% of at least one surfactant. So your invention should be covered broadly, but within the scope of invention, because alkyl ether sulfate is a surfactant and you can use that terminology in a broader way. Dimethicone is a conditioning agent, so you can use that terminology in claim one. You can define conditioning agent as, okay, conditioning agent is selected from dimethicone and etc. by giving more example. So you should write like 1 to 3% of antifungal agent instead of writing imidazole directly. So broader coverage of invention means you should cover your invention broadly by giving such terminology and by giving such percentages, so that your invention is covered in this composition also. Means if a controller asks, you have written, surfactant very bad, broadly, but you are only shampoo composition is working with alkyl ether sulfate, that time we can argue with the controller or justify by giving examples, although I am claiming this surfactant, but these are the surfactants can be used along with alkyl ether surfactant. Or third, you can just say, okay, if your antifungal agent is very important and you are saying, okay, otherwise it's going to very broad claim and etc., etc., you can define that antifungal agent in the claim one itself, saying wherein said antifungal agent is selected from the group consisting of dash 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 dash, give a laundry list of that chemicals and imidazo. Likewise, so I mean laundry list means you need to give such examples wherein if imidazole is working, a similar kind of component should be claimed in claim in such claims, saying ki, okay, if imidazole is working, this compound is should also work in a manner imidazole will work in the shampoo composition. Now this is what this is composition claim. As I said, now this is a product claim, means if you want to claim if you got a some novel compound while extracting or while synthesizing or while isolating from the natural product, etc., etc., you can claim that structure or that compound as a Marcuse claim. What is mean by Marcuse claim? Marcuse claim means you should not disclose your actual constituent in a claim one itself. However, you can write like R is selected from the group consisting of phenyl substituted phenyl or naphthyl, or can you see this structure? This is the basic moiety and I'm just writing R, R2 and R3 in that, and R1 can be anything selected from HCl, Br or blah blah blah. The actual compound will be covered in this invention. However, the inventor will get broader scope for their invention by claiming such Marcuse structure. Means you will get your rights for your compound also and rights for other compound also, saying okay, broader scope of invention for that compound. So claim drafting, I mean independent claim drafting is a really skillful task. It's very I can say it's an art of drafting that claims. Now process claim, what should be written in a process claim? Now your preamble is a process for example, here I have given example of oxidation of sulfenyl compound to sulfenyl compound. So a process for oxidizing a sulfenyl compound to sulfenyl compound, this is your preamble. Said process comprising, this is your transitional phase, the following steps, and A and B is your body of the claim. A, what we can say, reacting said sulfenyl compound with at least one acid in the presence of at least one phase reactor catalyst in a solvent to obtain solution, and adding at least one oxidizing agent to blah blah blah, exactly what you are doing. But you should write in a way that okay, just at least one phase transfer catalyst, instead of that some people write direct catalyst, some people write direct solvent if you are using toluene as a solvent, or if you are using any other catalyst directly, these people are writing claim one. Guys, just understand ki if you are writing that in a claim one, Indian patent office or government will give rights for that content only and not more than that. So to get a broader scope of invention and to get a broader rights for the claims, you should write claims in such a manner ki that should be broader, but that should be again within the scope of invention. Now after claims, your claims should be enabled in the examples, in the specification by way of giving examples. Example should be written in a past tense, of course, because inventors had done that and then he drafted the claim. That should be that is a protocol according to the Indian Patent Office. And in the examples, while you're writing example, you should give actual values. If you can keep trade secret for your invention, you can give little bit different values while writing experiments. You should not, it's not required to give exact what you did, but that should be similar what you did in the experiment section. So actual value should be given in the experiments. Ranges can't be given. Like if I'm saying 20 to 30% of alkyl ether or 5 to 15% of conditioning agent is used. In the example, I should write how, what is the exact percentage or what is the exact amount I have used, and which exact conditioning agent I have used, how I have mixed that thing, and then I got the shampoo composition. These all things should be written in a experimental part. And the experiment should be clearly mentioned. Trade names of the ingredients should be avoided in the experiment section, and in the claims also. That trade name should be chemical name of that trade mark or trade name should be given in claim if you have used that. And results from the experiment should be tabulated if you've done a lot of experiments, and then you can just give in a table format and give inference. Okay, see, that is the that was happening. This is the comparative example. If I'm not using dimethicone or if I'm not using surfactant, this much amount of surfactant, this will not work properly. So that data should be given in the specification. And you need to mention, okay, I have done so many experiments, but this is the best mode of my experiment. This is the best percentage, or this is the best component. This is the component which can be given best result. So experiments, after experiments, you can write abstract. That is again, as per Indian Patent Act, it should be, the abstract should be start with title of the invention on a separate page. It should contain 150 words. More than 150 words will not be allowed at the Indian Patent Office. Otherwise, you will get objection from the controller. And should be on a separate page, as I mentioned. Drawing or any formula, like any, suppose, as we just mentioned, the Marcuse claim, that compound can be written in an abstract, and should include the advantage of the invention in abstract part. So this is the type of, complete specification we can write. I reiterated that. Form one is different, that is inventors and inventor details are there. Form two is your complete or provisional specification. So in form two, on the first page, you should write title and applicant's name, etc., etc. Then you should write field of invention. As I mentioned, that should be again broad. Then after that, you need to write background of the invention. After that, you need to write objects, then summary, then detailed description, then experiments, then claims, and then abstract. So abstract is the last part, and this is just 150 word part. Claims are very important part of the specification, of the complete specification, as there is no claim in provisional specification. Why? Because provisional is just a conceptual idea you are filing, and you are getting the earliest priority date. Okay. So I have just taken this case study, how people are writing claims and how that should be written. As I said, claim should be in a one sentence. See, these people, what they have done, started with an improved process. They have given full stop here. That means their claim ended here itself. Again, full stop here, and again, full stop here. The controller had, objected on a very wrong note. I mean, he said, how you are writing this claim? How these people, what some of agent or whoever is writing, an improved process for the preparation of CBZ protected amine compound comprising the following features. It's not features, it's steps, because this is process. Then A, compounds containing primary or secondary amine groups were reacted with benzyl chloroformate at ambient temperature. Again, what is incorrect in that? It should not be in a past tense, were treated. Very incorrect language. Then they are directly saying benzyl chloroformate, means it's very narrow scope of the invention. Now, the claim should be clear at ambient temperature. What is mean by ambient temperature? Okay, room temperature. But room temperature is in Pune is different than in Jaipur. So, or in Delhi, or in South. So, ambient temperature means what? Worldwide, if we are claiming, the term ambient temperature is very vague. So that should be, you know, written like, okay, 20 to 50 degree pe I can, you know, do this process or like that. So ambient temperature or room temperature, such terminology should be avoided in claim one. Because this is very variable thing, you know, this temperature or whatever. So now second, the above said reaction has carried out under solvent free and catalyst free condition. See, now solvent free and catalyst free means what exactly they are doing? We don't know. I mean, nobody knows. Because your claim, whatever you are claiming, should be really clear, should be really concise, and what you want to get the protection is. That should be understood from your claim. Then after completion of reaction, ethyl acetate, very, very wrongly written ethyl acetate. This may, you know, this reaction may go with other solvent also. So you can just write solvent other if instead of ethyl acetate was added an organic layer extracted. Now this organic layer, where it comes from? Extracted by carbonate solution and brine, and finally concentrate under reduced pressure to obtain protected amine compound. So it's very, very untidy and shoddy claim, we can say. Claim should be very in a proper manner, should be corrected, should be written. So how can you write, okay, a process? I'm just telling you how to write. I mean, this is not the exact way to write. You can write another way also. I'm just, what we can say, suggesting few things in this claim is a process for the preparation of, or for a process for the preparation of CBZ protected amine compounds. Said process comprising the following steps. What is your step A? Treating. Now benzyl chloroformate ke liye you need to get a broader terminology. What this can be written as. Treating A compound with primary, with the amine group at a temperature in the range of so and so to obtain reaction mixture. Now, you can hear itself right, ki without devoid of solvent and devoid of catalyst to obtain a reaction mixture. After that, what you are doing, you are adding ethyl acetate and you are doing just workup here. So you can stop here itself. And this thing, this C content can be taken in a dependent claim. See, these are the dependent claim they have written that can be modified after what they have written. The mole ratio of amine group containing compound and benzyl chloroformate is 1:1. And the protection of amine groups were carried out with benzyl chloroformate. This is a very incorrect claim. As claimed in claim 1, preamble should be present in the claim 2 also. The process as claimed in claim 1, wherein said amine is primary amine or and secondary amine. That way you should write the claims. Then this is the case studies 2. I'm just telling you how the claim should not be written. See, this is the person has written 32.56 and 1.64. Oh my God, this is, you know, human error will happen in this case also. I mean, I can sometimes, because of air and because of that room temperature and because of whatever, I can take 1.7 by weight percent. And then what is the use of your invention? I can use your invention without infringing that claim, no? So if you are not stopping other person to use your invention, what is the use of claiming then? What is the use of filing the patent specification? So your invention should not be written like this. You should write the percentages of this components, whatever you are taking, and then you are giving a best way method in the specification and not in the claims. It's not required in the claims. So I can suggest this claim, maybe an effective amount of, an effective amount of, you know, and then see this can be given. Key effective amount can be this. Percentages can be given in that instead of writing actual amount in the claims. Now this is again very wrongly written claims, so I'll just avoid. And okay, just one example for proper claiming is if this is the process. Process for preparing alumina having surface area in the range of so and so. If you want to claim this content in claim one, if you want to claim, okay, it's not required in claim one, you can take this feature, that is surface area and pore volume and average pore diameter, in claim two. That is dependent claim. Whenever examiner or controller, you know, objects, you can take that in claim one. So again, I'm telling you, amendments are possible before till grant of the patent. So then said process comprising the following step: mixing at least one alumina source. Very broadly, we are saying keep alumina source. Now, which alumina source? You can define it in a dependent claim. In water to obtain an aqueous mixture. Mixing at least one templating agent. See, that templating agent, you can just again define it in a claim, dependent claim. Now you will get gel here. Now adjusting the pH of gel in the range of so and so. So you are giving broader coverage. If someone gets exact pH adjustment at 5, by, you know, adjusting this value, someone may work, I mean the invention may work at pH 6 also. That for that purpose, you need to claim the invention broadly. And then aging kar rahe hain aap, say aging said pH adjusted gel at a temperature so and so to obtain precipitate. Degree Celsius should be written properly. This is incorrect degree Celsius. Then what you are doing, you are filtering that precipitate, and then you are calcining and drying the precipitate to alumina. And this alumina property, this alumina has a property, you know, that has surface area in the range of so and so, pore volume in the range of so and so, and pore diameter in this range of so and so. So that should be written in a very proper, very you know, appropriate manner, because you should really think of the inventors ki they have did so much work on the invention, and they have spent so much money on that research. They have spent so much time, their intellect, their discussion, and that should be justified by giving broader set of claims, as governments will give rights to the independent claim and along with the dependent claim also. So I feel claim writing is a very, you know, big task, very interesting, very exciting. Each invention at this stage also we feel okay, how should be, you know, claimed, how the invention should be taken in claim one. That should be broad, that should be again inventive, should not considered by the examiner as obvious to a person skilled in that. So there are so many things for drafting. I feel okay, again, I request all students and professors and all faculty members that before going for publication, you should go for patent filing. There is not much, people are always, you know, in a impression that there are so many expenses for patenting and all, but it's not that. For natural person, very low amount is as a filing fees from the government. So you please go for patent filing, and after that you can go for publication, and accordingly we can, you know, create awareness in the IPR field. That's what I can say. Anything, any queries? There will be many queries after all. I mean, this is very new to you people. So I feel good if you can ask me something.
Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
It's a really informative session. We learn lots of from these slides and your discussion with you about different parts of the patents and how should one write or draft a patent. Okay, so I think there is no questions from participants. So shall we ask for questions from our end?
Sure.
Yes. So most of participants are the students. So can we give us the guidance about how to maintain the experimental data in laboratory notebook? So if someone wants to file a patent in future, how the data should be in the notebook?
Okay, so see, when you are going to go for research, you might have thought something, okay, I'm doing this, I'll be doing that, and I'll be doing this. So for that, you might have searched, you know, in Google or in any non-patent literature database or any patent databases, whatever, wherever it is, ki how this should go further. Then you must have thought, okay, these people are doing that and I should do this to overcome some problem which is, obtained or which can be, I can see in the prior art. So from there itself, the students or the professor or whoever is involved in that, they should maintain that, okay, these are the prior art I can see in Google, but this is my process and this is different than others. And how it is different, as soon as you get that idea, you just file provisional specification. Don't wait, okay, it will get success or not or whatever it is. Just don't go for that. You can file provisional specification ASAP at the earliest to get the priority date. After that, you can, you just maintain your reaction conditions, whatever you are doing, day-to-day basis, or how you failed at some extent, how you succeed at some extent. Maybe, see, at some temperature, reaction is not going. You should write it down there itself. And on that data, we can file complete specification. And the drafter, the drafter can suggest you, okay, this is the invention. This is already known in the art, but as per your experiments, this can be filed. This can be come up with novel and inventive feature in your claim one. So we always do that, but the maintain should be like how you processed with your idea to the experimental section. That's what I can say. But lab notebook is really required. Sometimes at the Indian Patent Office also, we provide such data saying, okay, this much efforts have been taken by the inventors. And after this much extensive experimentation, the inventor have come up with such solution or optimized reaction conditions. So on that also, they will grant a patent. And just I would like to mention, when you are applying for a patent, that is called patent application. And when you get a grant from the Indian Patent Office or from the central government, that is called patent. So people mistakenly use the word patent as always. But that should be written as a patent application, because that is in the application stage and not yet granted. Once you get a grant, you can just mention patent or granted patent like that.
Thank you, ma'am. So is there any ideal way to write the experimental notebook, like date, signature, like those things?
It's required. It's required. Date and signature, based on your EA, but date is required. Because if I'm doing experiments today, and if I'm filing that tomorrow, or maybe I'm filing that tomorrow, but you are filing after 1 month with same thing, right? But based on your data, based on your notebook dates, I can say, okay, this is my invention, this I did before you, and I have filed before you, and this is my proof. So date is really important, I can say. Signature is, that is up to you but date is important.
Thank you. Yeah. So there is one question in chat box. whether we should validate our practical results from any agency for patent results.
Exactly what validation means, what exactly you mean to say?
Suppose we perform any experiment and we found that the results are innovative. So should we validate those results again from some
Not required. Why? You should be confident about your invention. There is no requirement of any validation while filing patent application or while arguing at the Indian Patent Office before the controller, during hearing or during prosecution stage. It's not required.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am. So, ma'am, would you please focus, enlighten us on what the patent examination is and what exactly they cross-check in that process?
Okay. So, when we file a patent, I'm just going up for a complete specification. When we file complete specification, within 18 months, Indian Patent Office will publish that. And as soon as your turn comes, now examination is going as per, Indian Patent Office module. So as soon as your turn comes, before that, again, after filing specification, you need to file request for examination within 48 months from the date of priority. Means within 4 years from the date of priority. Whatever date you are filing, your request for examination should be filed along with fees at the Indian Patent Office. If you are not filing that request for examination within 48 months, your application will not be examined by Indian Patent Office. That will get abandoned. Okay, now once you file request for examination, the controller or the examiner will examine this invention, like your peer reviews, how these people does, journal ke liye peer review vagera hota hai na, वैसे examiner will search your scope of invention in their databases, patent databases as well as non-patent literatures, and they will come up saying, okay, this is the documents I received, which this is novelty destroying, or this is not inventive, this is very obvious to a person skilled in that, and etc. So if the controller is citing such document, we need to argue to the controller, we need to give justification by filing our response or by filing amendments in the claims along with the response, saying how my invention is novel and how my invention is not obvious to a person skilled in that. It is really inventive based on this feature. So that explanation we should give at the Indian Patent Office within 6 months from the first examination report. So after filing the draft response, after filing the response to the first examination report, the controller may grant your application, or he may give hearing. Hearing means you can just explain your invention to the controller, ki how this is inventive, how this is not obvious to a person skilled in that, and how this prior art cited by you in the examination report or during the hearing, it's not relevant. That we can argue. And amendments to the claims is we can do till grant of the patent. So this way, examination happen.
Okay.
Yeah. But this is very routine procedure. I mean, these students and professors, faculty members should understand this is very routine procedure, and examiners are doing their job, they are just finding some prior art and they are coming up with, okay, this is your invention is not novel, or your invention is very obvious. But that is our job to say, okay, this is my invention and this is not obvious to a person skilled in that. So we always get a chance to explain what is our invention in view of your thought process, so that is a very good thing always. At all patent offices, means US, EP, whatever, in India, whatever. Yeah.
Right. Thank you, ma'am. So, we would also like to know about what is the patent maintenance, and if the patent life is 20 years from the patent filing, so do we require to maintain to every patent?
So what is patent maintenance? See, when you are applying for a patent, and then when you are you got a grant for a patent. So from the grant of the from the grant till 20 years, you need to pay some annuity amount to the Indian Patent Office, saying this is I'm maintaining the patent. If you will not pay the that amount, there is not much amount. If you will not pay that amount, your patent get abandoned. Because see, this is rights government government is giving to you for the claims, which you can stop other people from selling, exporting, or importing, or etc., etc. So for that, you know, it's like little bit money Indian Patent Office will charge for maintaining that patent. But that is not a big amount. Again, जो लाइक लोगों को बहुत है कि पेटेंट में बहुत पैसे जाते हैं एंड ऑल ऑल, बट ऐसा नहीं है. आई मीन इट्स नॉट दैट वे. सो यू शुड एक्चुअली फाइल सो मेनी पेटेंट्स. एज आई कैन सी सो मेनी मेंबर्स फ्रॉम द योर स्टूडेंट्स एंड फैकल्टी मेंबर्स, आई कैन सी देर आर सो मेनी पार्टिसिपेंट. सो एटलीस्ट 5-10 पेटेंट शुड बी एप्लीकेशन शुड बी फाइल ईयरली एटलीस्ट.
Yes. So we have one participant. Just a minute.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So there is one question from participant. If we publish our invention in journal, can we make some changes and file patent?
No. See, your own journal will cite as a prior art then at the examination stage, if examiner find your journal in Google or in non-patent databases, that journal itself will be cited by the examiner, and then you need to defend ki how this is different. If you are very sure ki okay, this can be done, then you can go for that. But again, inventive step ka issue aayega ki how this is inventive. If you are doing some modification in earlier research which you have published in journal, so you need to you need to provide the arguments ki how it is inventive, how it is not obvious to a person skilled in that. Okay, I just want to mention there is some logon ko lagta hai ki mera khud ka journal mein hai to mera hi kaise cite hoga, but this is not the case. This is in public domain. Now your journal, your content is in a public domain, and your journal can be cited also for your application. So, ऐसा नहीं है कि मेरा जर्नल है तो मेरा ही कैसे साइट हो रहा है और मेरा ही है तो मुझे ग्रांट होना चाहिए. ऐसा दिस इज नॉट द यू नो वे, दिस इज नॉट द केस.
ओके, देयर इज वन मोर क्वेश्चन रिगार्डिंग पेटेंट सर्च. सो व्हाट इज पॉसिबल वेज टू से एग्जैक्ट दैट दिस थिंग्स आर पेटेंटेड और नॉट? हाउ वी कैन सर्च द नोवेल्टी ऑफ आवर वर्क?
You can search in Google, or if you have any databases like SciFinder or any non-patent databases like PubChem, or generally Google pe search kar lena hai. You can see, and if you want to go thoroughly, you can go for there are many organizations who can do novelty search reports, patentability search reports, and based on that you can go for filing provisional or complete specification. That is the best way. Before filing, no, you need to have a search.
Okay. One last question from our end. So in academics, like many patents people file, so many times they struggle to commercialize their inventions. So if they want to transfer their technology, so how they should go, and what are the platforms where they can display their inventions?
See, after filing patent application, you can discuss, you can wherever you want to publish and etc., etc. But for filing and licensing, you need to be in that I mean, you have to have that contacts, you know, networking and all. Either otherwise, you can just contact with some other law firms or organization who can help you in this matter. Or you can directly contact to that person or that management saying, okay, this is my invention and I want to license. And there is assignment deed is there, license agreements are there. This is really legal procedure, you know. Okay. Yeah.
Thank you very much for all the detailed description of our questions.
Yeah, I hope you people will file many application in recent days. Yeah. Sure. For any help, you can call us for filing or for anything, for any doubt, because we are there to help you in any manner in IPR. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Right. So with your permission, shall we conclude the session?
Yes, sir. Sure.
Yes.